Last time we talked about partial fractions when all of the factors of the denominator were linear. In other words, when all of the roots of the denominator are real. Now we're going to talk about what happens when you get quadratic factors. The general idea is almost the same, but the process of finding the coefficients is a bit trickier, and doing the integrals when you're done is also a little bit trickier. So let's take a look at this example. Suppose we want to compute this integral. And we notice that the denominator, it's x cubed plus x. And if we factor x cubed plus x, you get a linear factor x. And you get a quadratic factor x squared plus 1. And there's no way to factor that x squared plus 1 further. It's called irreducible if you can't factor it further. So when we try to write it as a partial fraction, remember we're looking at fractions where the numerator has fewer powers of x than the denominator. And the rule is that every term you have to allow the numerator to have everything up to one fewer power of x than the denominator. Now if you're doing something over x, then the numerator can't have any powers of x. It just has to be a constant. That's what we were dealing with last time. But if the denominator is quadratic, then the numerator can be linear. If you got an x squared in the denominator, the numerator isn't a constant, it's a constant times x plus another constant. So there are two constants to figure out with regard to this factor, and only one with regard to that one. Okay, so the way we figure out the constants is the same as before. We multiply through both sides by x squared plus x. And that gives us the numerator equals a times x squared plus 1 plus bx plus c times x. And if we wanted, we could rewrite this as bx squared plus cx. And now we have to figure out, how to make things work. And now we've run into a problem because we found that the best things to plug in were the roots of the polynomial. But there aren't any roots to x squared plus 1. No matter what value of x you pick, x squared plus 1 is going to be bigger than 1. So you don't have any of those roots, and so how are we going to find a, b, and c? There are two techniques for this. The first one says, you know what, plugging in roots is good, but we can plug in any numbers we want. So let's just plug in numbers and get some equations. So here's what we're trying to solve, and this has got to be true for every value of x. And so we still have a root of the other term, so we can plug in x equals 0. We plug in x equals 0, this term disappears, and you get 3 equals a. Wonderful, we've got a. And then you say, well, let's plug in some other values of x. And you can pick whichever ones you want. You could plug in 17, you could plug in negative 32, but of course, those are complicated. The easiest ones to plug in are simple numbers like 1. If you plug in 1, the left-hand side is 6, and the right-hand side is 2a plus b plus c. And since a is 3, that tells you that 0 is b plus c. And then I'm going to plug in x equals 2. Maybe it would have been simpler to plug in x equals minus 1, but x equals 2 is pretty nice. It's a simple number that you can plug in, and you get 8 plus 2 plus 3, that's 13, is a times 2 squared plus 1, that's 5a, plus 2b plus c times 2, so that's 4b plus 2c. And you plug in the value of a that we already know, and we get these two equations become 0 is b plus c, and negative 2 is 4b plus 2c. And then you can subtract twice this equation from this equation, and you get that b is negative 1 and c is 1. And we already had that a was 3. Now, the other method says if you have two polynomials that are equal, then their coefficients of x squared have to be the same, and their coefficients of x have to be the same, and their coefficients of 1 have to be the same. So we're trying to figure out this is the same equation we had before, only now I've put all the quadratic things in red, and the linear terms in green, and the constant terms in blue. And we say, hey, this has 2x squared, and this has a plus bx squared, so we have to have a plus b being 2. This has 1x, and this has cx, So we've got to have 1 equals c. This has a 3 left over, and this has an a left over, so we have to have 3 equals a. And from these three equations, well, we have a and we have c, and plugging the value of a back into this will give you b, and we get the same answers that we had before. Whichever way you do it, you break it down and you say our original fraction was 3 over x plus minus x plus 1 over x squared plus 1, and then we integrate each term separately. The first term gives natural log of x. The second term, we do a u substitution. Let u equals x squared plus 1, so du is 2x dx. We get 1 half of the natural log of x squared plus 1. And this, we remember, is we get an arctangent. And then we get a constant, and this constant is not the constant c that we had before, but we always use c for our arbitrary constant. Okay. Now, the integrals to remember when doing this are a little bit more complicated than with the linear factors. Linear factors, you integrate 1 over x plus a, and you just get the natural log of x plus a. But when you have a quadratic factor, you do it by doing the u substitution, u equals x squared plus a squared, du equals 2x dx. So this becomes 1 half du over u, which gives you 1 half the log of u plus a constant. And when you have 1 over x squared plus a squared, you do the trig substitution, x equals a tangent theta, and when all the dust settles, you get 1 over a times the arctangent of x over a plus a constant. So the integrals are a bit more complicated than the linear ones, but you can do them. Finally, there's a question of what happens if you have multiple factors or repeated factors. So if somebody gave us a polynomial with this big messy thing, we could just apply partial fractions. We got 1 power of x, so we have a over x. We have 2 powers of x minus 1, so we have an x minus 1 and an x minus 1 squared. We have 1 power of x squared plus 9, so we have something over x squared plus 9, and that something has a linear and a constant piece, and then we have something over x squared plus 1 and something over x squared plus 1 squared. And those have linear and constant pieces too. So it would be fx plus g hx plus I. Now that's a lot of constants to work out, but the same procedure that we did before can work things out. And then when you have to integrate all of these, whenever you have to integrate an x over a quadratic thing, you do a u substitution where u is x squared plus a squared. When you don't have an x, you do a trig substitution, x equals a tangent of theta. And if it's not just x squared plus a squared, if it's something more complicated, then you have to complete the square.